stella, vado in laguna e voglio cantar. Mi sa il gondolier che in gondola tenno, se il remmo in forcola s'ingiò, poverezza il signor sarebbe.
Why I am so sad. It wearies me. You say it wearies you. But how I caught it, found it, or came by it, what stuff it is made of, whereof it is born, I am to learn. Oh, and such a want-wit sadness makes of me that I have much ado.
I, Master Lorenzo, and the rest. But we will visit you at supper time.
Father's child. But though I am a daughter to his blood, I'm not to his manners. Oh, Lorenzo, if thou keep promise, I shall end this strife, become a Christian and thy loving wife. Haste, Lorenzo, haste away. patience I shall die. Come and ease thy Jesse's care. Let me then in wanton play, sighing gaze my soul away. Let me then in wanton play, sighing gaze my soul away.
Nay, we will slink away at supper time, disguise us at my lodgings, and return all in an hour.
We have not made good preparation.
We have not spoke as yet of torch bearers.
'Tis vile, unless it may be quaintly ordered, and better in my.
And if my fortune be not crossed, I have a father, you a daughter, lost.
The penthouse under which Lorenzo desired us to make stand.
His hour is almost past.
And it is marvel he outdwells the hour, for lovers ever run before the clock.
Oh, 10 times faster Venus pigeons fly to seal love's bonds you made. But they are wont to keep alive faith unforfeited. Here comes Lorenzo.
Sweet friends, your patience for my long abode. Not I, but my affairs have made you wait. When you shall please to play the thieves for wives, I'll watch as long for you then. But approach. Here dwells my father Duke. Home, who's within?
Who are you? Tell me for more certainty, or be it, I swear I do know your tongue.
Lorenzo, and thy love.
Lorenzo certain, and my love indeed. For who love I so much? And now who knows but you, Lorenzo, whether I'm yours?
Heaven and thy thoughts are witness that thou art.
Here, catch this casket. 'Tis worth the pains. I'm glad 'tis night and you do not look upon me, for I'm much ashamed of my exchange. But love is blind, and lovers cannot see the pretty follies themselves commit. For if they could, Cupid himself would blush to see me thus transformed to a boy.
Descend, for you must be my torchbearer.
What? Must I hold a candle to my shames? They in themselves, good sooth, are too light. Why, love is an office of discovery, and I should be obscured.
So are you, sweet, even in the lovely garnish of a boy. But come at once. The close night has played a runaway, and we are stayed for at Bassanio's feast.
I will make fast the doors and gild myself with some more ducats, and be with you straight.
Now, by my hood, a Gentile and no Jew.
Beshrew me, but I love her heartily. For she is wise if I can judge of her. And fair she is if mine eyes be true. And true she is, for she hath proved herself. Therefore like herself, wise, fair and true, shall she be placed in my constant soul. What? Art thou come? On, gentlemen, away!
A young Venetian, who comes before to signify the approaching of his lord. He bringeth from him sensible regrets to wit, besides commends and courteous breath, gifts of rich value. I think that I...
I think he only loves the world for him. I pray you, let us go find him out and quicken his embraced heaviness with some delight or other.
Do we so.
On the Rialto.
Why, yet it lives so unchecked that Antonio hath a ship of rich lading wrecked upon the narrow seas. The good winds, I think, they call the place a very dangerous, flat and fatal, where the carcasses of many a tall ship lie buried. I live upon the rack, but let me to my fortune and the caskets.
Away then. I am locked in one of them. If you do love me, you will find me out. Nerissa and the rest, stand all aloof. Let music sound whilst he doth make his choice. Then if he lose, he make a swan-like end. Fade in your music.
First, with gold, which this inscription bears, who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire.
Second, silver, which this promise carries.
Who chooseth me shall get as much as he deserves.
Third, dull lead.
Warning all as blunt. Who chooseth me must give and hazard all he hath.
Shall I know if I do choose the right?
Than doth promise aught. Thy paleness moves me more than eloquence. And here choose I. Oh, let joy be the consequence. Find I here.
My letter. Oh, love. Dispatch all business and be gone.
Since I have your good leave to go away, I will make haste. But till I come again, no bed shall e'er be guilty of my stay. No rest be interposed twixt us twain.
this is the fool that lent our money gratis. Gaoler, look to him.
Hear me yet, good Shylock.
I'll have my bond. Speak not against my bond. I've sworn an oath that I will have my bond. Thou callest me dog before thou hadst a cause. Well, since I am a dog, beware my fang.
How sweet the moonlight sleeps upon this bank. Here will we sit and let the sound of music creep in our ears. Soft stillness in the night become the touches of sweet harmony. Sit, Jessica. Look how the floor of heaven is thick inlaid with patines of bright gold. There's not the smallest orb which thou would beholdest, but in his motion, like an angel sings, still choiring to the young-eyed cherubims, such harmonies are in immortal souls. But while this muddy vesture of the cave doth grossly close it in, we cannot hear it. Come home and wake Diana with a hymn. With sweetest touches, pierce your mistress's ear and draw her home with music.
I'm never merry when I hear sweet music.
The reason is, your spirits are attentive. For do but note, a wild and wanton herd, or a race of youthful and unhandled colts, fetching mad bounds, bellowing and neighing loud, which is the hot condition of their blood. If they should but hear perchance a trumpet sound, or any air of music touch their ears, you shall perceive in them make a mutual stand, their savage eyes turn to a modest gaze by the sweet power of music. Therefore the poet did feign that Orpheus drew trees, stones and floods, since naught so stockish, hard and full of rage, but music for the time doth change his nature. The man that hath no music in himself, nor is not moved with concord of sweet sounds, is fit for treasons, stratagems and spoils. The motions of his spirit are as dull as night, and his affections dark as Erebus. Let no such man be trusted. Mark the music.
Thyself no wrong, my dear, away with every jealous fear, for each pair of the time I see, the fat is far a thought of thee, as a suspense to scorn the play, the lad that comes so slow, and distant points with joy.
So shines a good deed in a naughty world.
When the moon shone, we did not see the candle.
So does a greater glory dim the less? Methinks a substitute shines as brightly as the king, unto the king be by. Then his state empties itself, as doth an inland brook into the main of waters. Music, hark!
It is your music, madam, of the house.
Nothing is good, I see, without respect. Methinks it sounds much sweetly than by day.
Silence bestows that virtue on it, madam.
The crow doth sing as sweetly as the lark when neither is attended. And I think the nightingale, if she should sing by day when every goose is cackling, would be thought no greater musician than the wren. Peace. The moon sleeps with Endymion and would not be awake.
That is a voice, so I'm much deceived, of Portia.
He knows me as the blind man knows the cuckoo, by the bad voice.
Dear lady, welcome home.
We have been praying for our husband's health, which speed, we hope, the better. All things faithfully.
The first interrogatory that my Nerissa shall be sworn on is whether till the next night she had rather stay or go to bed now, being 2 hours today. But were the day come, I should wish it dark that I were couching with the doctor's clerk. Well, so long as I live, I'll fear no other thing so sore as keeping safe Nerissa's ring.